What's good, YouTube? This is your main man, Ned Jones, reporting live from the 215. And today I'm bringing you a creator legend. Yeah, that's right, with Ricky Rubio. Now I know a lot of y'all are like, Ricky Rubio? Why not Kemba Walker? Why not Jimmy Fredette? Why not Derrick Williams? I'ma tell you why. It's a lot of cats. A lot of cats that I had seen up on YouTube doing Creator Legends with Kemba Walker. I know my homie, a weird creepy guy, he's doing one with Jimmy Fredette. My other homie, Shadow Beach, is doing one with Derrick Williams. So, you know, I'ma switch it up, man. I'm not trying to be like everybody else, so that's what I'ma do. I'ma bring y'all Ricky Rubio, Creator Legend, basically like the life of Ricky Rubio. Man, I'ma show you his crib, you know. I'm gonna hit the mall with him, buy some stuff, some sneaks, furniture for his crib. Man, I got a whole lot of store for you guys, man. So, you know, as I sit here and gear him up, getting ready for this opening day, we're gonna get right into it, so hope you enjoy. This is your man, Air Jones. And I'm gone, and I'm gone, and I'm gone, and I'm gone, and I'm gone. Hello, my name is Ricky Rubio, and this is my crib. Okay, this is the picture of me holding up my jersey for the Minnesota Timberwolves. This right here is a small island back home. Come on guys, let's go over here. Now this sofa right here is imported from Paris. It's very, 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 very comfortable. Very comfortable. Now this plasma TV that you guys see, that was a gift from the Minnesota Timberwolves. Really like my TV. This is another picture of me after the draft that I was drafted. This is my next fireplace. Let's go outside. Sorry guys, I just moved in. I really don't have a lot of furniture. But as you see, I have a great view. This is my jacuzzi. Hot tub. You know, as you guys will call it. Let's go back inside the house. It's kind of cold. My new kitchen. And that's my desert eagle. Just in case somebody tries to try me. Okay, let's go upstairs. This right here, it's a preseason game. It's the Philadelphia 76ers. And that is me dunking. Okay. And this right here is my first magazine, Brandon Jennings. Upstairs to my bedroom. These trophies right here, won those back home. And this is my money. This is my bed with my plasma TV in front of it. Look at that handsome guy. Let's take a look at this view outside. And that's really it, guys. So I showed you everything. My TV, my kitchen, my outside. Thanks for coming, my name is Ricky Rubio. I'll see you at the game tonight.
It's opening day all around the NBA. We're happy to be with you as we tip off the season with Clark Kellogg and Steve Kerr. This is Kevin Harlan. We're looking forward to another fantastic year.
One in the playoff team a year ago, and they won their share of games, but they didn't appear to be a contender.
What's good, YouTube? Here is Rubio. This is xJawz again. I'm bringing you Ricky Rubio's first NBA basketball game. My man just finds me for that wide open Jimmy. So I knock it down. You know, before I get into anything, man, I want to talk to y'all about a couple things. First, man, I want to apologize for my first commentary on my SoCom 4 video. And that last commentary on get that shit out of here. Last commentary on my Let's Ball video. I mean, I gotta be honest, man. Those commentaries is, come on, man. You gotta finish that. Come on, man. We in the pros now. You gotta finish that shit. You messing my dimes up. Yeah, but I gotta apologize, man. Those commentaries is just straight ass, man. I must be honest. Those is ass. But you know, after watching a couple of those had to be a commentator videos. I kind of learned a lot from those. So, you can't do nothing about that but just take that on the chin, man. It's a good shot. But, yeah, man, I learned a lot from, from listening to WyzaNow, IKC, homie Shakedown, you know, and just, you know, a couple tips from my boy QJB, big homie kspade. And, you know, it just, I don't know, man, I guess it was just me just being nervous and trying to be perfect or whatnot. But, you know, I'm just going to just sit back, be myself, just be air, you know. I'm not trying to, you know, be something I'm not. So, yeah, as we, you know, in the first quarter. Oh, yeah, I had to chop this game up, man. It was about half an hour long. And, dimes. It's about a half an hour long, so, you know, I didn't want to, you know, bore you guys too much. As, you know, I try to create something and get it going. As we locked up at 18 up, or 19-18 now in the second quarter. Yeah, I didn't want you guys to fall asleep on me. But, yeah, man, I picked up Ricky Rubio because, man, it's a lot of cats using Kimball. Oh, look at that shot. Sheesh. That's a good move right there, Kurt. And by the way, man, Kurt was lighting my ass up. But, you know, I was getting back at him, too, as you can see right there. I was just shaking bacon, taking to the rack. But, yeah, I had to pick up Ricky Rubio. Because a lot of cats, man, every video I see, man, people either got Kemba Walker or Kyrie Irving. So I was like, you know what, I always play a big man. Let me go ahead and just do something different. Ooh, good D. Good D. Let me go ahead and do something different and just, you know, step out of my, you know, my comfort zone. Let me go get a point guard and try to make the plays. Oh, look at that dom. Look at that dom right there. Matter of fact, let's take a look at that again. Look at that. Oh, man. Yeah, man. But, so, I'm going to try something new. So basically, I think Ricky Rubio's a good fit for the Timberwolves. You know, with all the weapons that they have. I mean, not taking nothing away from you know, Lou Ridnour or JJ Barrera. But you know, that just makes that position stronger right there. But you know, the GM and a lot of the Timberwolves fans are banking on him, you know, be their basically their spark. Oh, as it just gets shit rejected. Basically, that spark that they, you know, that they need. Because, you know, they've been kind of down ever since KG had left. So, they're really just trying to find an identity right now. But, basically, what you can expect, man, from this series is just trying to, I wouldn't say improve his passing. Because his passing is already like a high 86, 88. So basically, I'm just going to try to like max his passing out. And the main thing is on-ball defense, as you can just see. As you can see, been getting my ass beat basically the whole game from dimes. Been getting my ass beat the whole time from basically the whole game from Jeff Teague and Kurt Heinrich. So that's a big thing, man. You got to work on his on-ball D. There's a lot of good point guards out there. Well, athletic point guards. And that's bullshit right there. My man was all over him. It's all good, Darko. But there's a lot of good athletic point guards out there. Like, you know, Russell Westbrook. How long do you think it's going to take to rebuild this team? Rajon Rondo. I mean, he's kind of quick. Chris Paul. Shannon Brown, you know, the list goes on, man. But yeah, I'm gonna try to step his D up a little bit, you know. Basically try to make him a more offensive threat. Oh, look at that. Oh man, that's bullshit. Give me that back. Oh man, that's whack. But watch this right here. Look at this D. That's what I'm gonna bring right there. I'm gonna try to. I mean, kind of got lucky with that. He was trying to force his way past the line. But, he almost lose the ball there. Trying to find my man Beasley to get something going. Basically trying to make him, like, more of an offensive threat. You know, more of, like, a shooter. Kind of like a slasher. You know what I'm saying? But, yeah, that's what you can, that's what you can expect. And as he misses that, man gets the rebound. Pushing it up right now. It's 42-40 with 3 minutes left. Try to get something going. Man Beasley drops it down. This game gets crazy as the time winds down. I'm trying to lock up Kurt Heinrich. He's been cooking me all game. Grady been going off all game. And that's just something you just got to deal with right there, man. Like I said, you got to take that on the chin. Try to find love. Try to get him going. He passes it back to me. I'm off with that. Now T pushes the ball up the court. 2 minutes left. Try to help out Kevin Love. Can't get it to go. Good D by Love. Rebound by Williams. Bringing the ball up. Try to find him. Dimes. Dimes all day. They call a timeout. Now, mind you, I gotta. I'm trying to stay on Kurt, man. I'm trying to stay on him. He's been lighting me up. Give me that cookies. Showtime. Basically, as my man kspade would say, chestnuts. Shout out to Josh Smith being in Ricky Rubio's first poster. You really hate to see it come to an end. I agree. Well, then let's root for overtime. Why not? Yeah, with a minute 45 left. Trying to basically make sure I can contain them. Trying to stay on Kurt. Trying to help my man out. He's been getting abused down at a point. Whoa. Hold up. Oh, that's that bullshit right there. As you can see, I guess I got penalized for coach didn't like me reaching in, so he sat me on the bench. And he lost the game. And as you can see, Ricky Rubio isn't too happy either. So that's it for episode 1. Catch y'all later. It's Ed Jones, and I'm signing out.